welcome to Neutral Site Action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. And now the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. That excites. Florida Atlantic is ready to open this one up as they line up for the opening kick. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Pulls it in and stopped in his tracks with that tackle. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. There to knock it away. Now it's going to be fourth down.
Nice defense. That was picture perfect three and out. Good series for these guys.
That brings us fourth and seven.
It's away. Short punt. And he's taken down at the 48. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. The stop at the 47.
There's nothing better than having an athletic, versatile, and instinctive safety. He makes a big-time play here with his recognition of the run, comes up and does what he does best, which is making a nice, sure tackle on the ball carrier.
From their own 47-yard line, it's second down. He's going to try and scramble, and he's going to be sacked. They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
Stood tall there.
Boy, the defense did what they had to do to get three and out and now get the offense back on the field.
That makes it fourth and one.
And down he goes at the 29-yard line. I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. Quick throw, tackle made at the 27-yard line. Second down and 11. Ball on the 27-yard line. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. Here they come. Fires that quickly, incomplete.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
It's a short kick. Signals for a fair catch. And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter. Makes the catch, and look out. He's knocked out of bounds at the 48-yard line.
What we're seeing right now is just a great connection between the quarterback and his receivers. They make these plays look effortless.
Got it and brought down immediately. Taken down at the 41-yard line. 7-yard gain, and that'll be a first down.
Nice protection, a good pass, and even a better catch. You can't ask for much more than that.
It was a great read by the quarterback there to take the snap and throw it quickly to get the first. Nice run there. And a quick throw. At the 29. So the completion goes for about 8 yards and a first down.
They've done a great job on this drive with the underneath pass. The quarterback isn't forcing the ball, and you can see how effective he is.
They'll bring him down at the 20. Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. Sets them up with a first and goal.
Hey, kill, kill, kill.
There's a strike complete. Touchdown, Florida Atlantic.
For the passing game, it was absolutely the right call in that situation.
And he converts the extra point. An 8-play, 63-yard, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
An amazing drive for this offense. Outstanding execution. If you're the defense, you've got to do something to try to change things up to get this quarterback out of sync.
The score now, 7-0. Right. The 21-yard line. The Owls are smothering the opposition so far today. What's this offense got to do to get off the schneid?
Well, you've talked to offensive coordinators about, and they'll say we've got to find our go-to guy. Who are our players that we know we can count on? And what are the plays that we typically feel the most confident about? That's usually where the offenses tend to go when they're getting shut down.
Caught and a big hit. He stopped in his tracks. Here's the handoff, and he's taken down for a loss. Third and 9. Ball on the 22. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. And down he goes, around the 37-yard line.
He showed you right there why a defense can never lose tabs on him. Take your eye off him in coverage, and he'll create a big play.
The quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. And he's tackled around the 48-yard line. They'll spread the field with 5 wide. Throws it in a hurry, and he's taken down right around the 48-yard line. Out to his receiver. He's tackled at about the 33-yard line. That makes it first and 10. They come out in a 5-wide set. strike and he drops it. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Brought down at the 18-yard line. Five wide. They'll work the left side. And they hit him in the backfield. We've played one quarter. The Owls lead 7-0. Welcome you back to the action here. Just about set to start the second quarter. Just throws this one away. It's 3rd and 13. Ball on the 21-yard line. They come out on an empty backfield. Big play, and it's 1st and goal.
That makes it 1st and goal.
They try to get a head start there.
False start, offense.
Maybe he got the cadence wrong coming out of the huddle. The coaches have a low threshold for mistakes like that.
A touchdown away from a tie. Quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. And he adds the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 27. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. He makes it to the 28-yard line. There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened. From their own 28-yard line. Second down. Got an opening. He's to the 40. Makes it to the 44. He's at the 40, and he hits him hard at the 34-yard line. Caught it, but they're going to lose yards. He was tackled immediately. That'll be a 2-yard loss.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
From the 36-yard line. Second down.
Ready? And two, and go!
Slings it. And they make the stop at the 33-yard line.
Come up short here on third down to be able to pick up this first down, but at least they're in field goal range, and a smart coach will always take 3 points when he gets an opportunity.
So they're going to go for it here. The Owls running back, he was injured earlier. You see him down there on the sideline, and it looks like he's ready to get back in the game. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch. He's scrambling, and he's going to come up with a sack. From the 21-yard line, second down. Gets rid of this one. That was incomplete, and it looked exactly like their last pass.
It was exact same play, and I think the offensive coordinator just tried to pull a fast one.
This is the 10th play of this drive. Complete pass and hit hard as he came down with it. That'll be a gain of 3 yards.
Nice grab there by the tailback to at least move the ball forward for some positive yards.
They'll line it up for the field goal. Florida Atlantic could take the lead with this field goal. He gets it up, and it sails through the uprights. They line up to kick this one away. He's out to the 30. Gets to about the 34-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. And he tackles him hard at the 49-yard line.
Nothing tentative on that run at all. He looked very determined and got the first down.
They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. That's a great tackle at the 41. Catches it. He's immediately tackled behind the line. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. And this may be fourth down territory if they can't get a first down here. And off up the middle, and he's stuck. Convert on fourth down, and the ball changes hands. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Florida Atlantic holds a field goal lead. They'll knock him down for a loss. And that play was snuffed out from the get-go.
You're right. This is a delayed handoff to the tailback, and the defense wasn't fooled at all there.
From their own 45-yard line, it's second down. Makes the catch, and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss. Tackled back behind the line of scrimmage. And that was a really well-played series by the defense.
This is the kind of solid, consistent play you look for in your defense. Let's see if the offense can follow it up.
Yeah. 34. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
Here we go.
Here comes the pressure, and he throws it away. From their own 34-yard line, it's second down. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. And he's level at the 48. They'll spread the field with five wide. Tackle made at the 36. Airing it out long. Incomplete. He tried to hit his receiver in stride, but overthrew it a little too much.
That'll come in time. Just repetition, throwing that same pass over and over, and he'll be fine.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line. Picked off. Nice interception and an even nicer vertical.
Oh, yeah. This guy's an athlete. There's no throwing it over this guy's head. He'll go up and get it.
From their own 20-yard line, it's first down. Florida Atlantic has a three-point lead. And he is drilled at the 31-yard line.
Just a simple draw play there, but they picked up some big yards.
The Owls are going to call their second timeout. And he's going to be sacked.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation.
And two, three, eight.
Kill, kill, kill. Flare.
As a man, he'll lose big yards. Well, we're headed to halftime now. We're seeing two defenses that don't want to give an inch. 10-7, Owls. Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. Gathered in at the six. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. We're about set to start things up again. Florida Atlantic is up by three. Gives it left side. Runs it left for a decent game. Quick shot to the tailback and through his hands.
Number 22, the intended receiver.
from their own 30-yard line. It's third down. Setting up blockers, or running backs got it on the screen. Tackle at the 32.
That makes it fourth and four.
And he can't hang on to the ball.
So that's exactly what happens when you take your eyes off the ball. Concentration for return man is of the utmost importance.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Quick pass. He's taken down at the 36-yard line. Catches it, and that's all. Looks left, picked off. He came up with a fantastic interception there.
Well, you know the quarterback is kicking himself for that one. He just made the wrong read.
From their own 28-yard line. First down. Florida Atlantic is up a field goal. Knocked out of bounds at the 37-yard line.
The quarterback and his receiver make a great play here and convert on an early down.
Receiver. He's at the 40. They'll bring him down right around the 36-yard line. He's got an opening. He's tackled at the 23. He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
Catches it, and he's punished.
Kill, kill, kill! Three, nine,
ten. Pulls it in and stopped in his tracks with that tackle. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Down around the 2-yard line. Florida Atlantic holds a field goal lead. Touchdown, Owls. To perfection for the score.
It's a great job by the quarterback to read the defense. He made a nice pitch to the running back and let him go in for 6.
And he converts the extra point. And 8-play, 73-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. Whoa, he just took a licking. Offense comes back out, looking to improve from their last effort.
And I don't think this defense will lay down lightly. They're going to try to continue to rattle this guy.
And he's tackled around the 22-yard line. There was just no daylight on that play, and the defensive lineman was the reason.
Well, that's one way to get involved in the game. Great stop in the backfield.
And he's taken down at the 21-yard line. From their own 21-yard line, third down. Going long. And down he goes at about the 27-yard line.
You know, they did a great job here of not just getting past the first down marker, but picking up some major yards on the play.
It out, and they make the stop at the 18.
That brings up second and one.
Zips it to the tight end. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
He makes it out to maybe the 7-yard line. He gets out to about the 6-yard line. And Herbie, we've got a guy down after that play. Well, let's see what they do here. It's third and goal from the 6. Hit immediately. And they can make this a one possession game with this kick right here. Kicks away, and he's got it. Southern Miss ready to kick this one off. He'll return it from the 6. And he's tackled at the 26-yard line.
Kirk, if this keeps going like it has been, we are going to have one exciting fourth quarter.
I just hope we continue to see this kind of execution. It's a lot of fun to be able to watch these offenses make plays, and it kind of has that feel. Whoever does have the ball last and a chance to make a play could win this game.
They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in 6. Florida Atlantic is up by a touchdown. Gets to about the 27-yard line. He's got it with room to run. Tackle made at the 38-yard line. Three down and one to go. The Owls with a touchdown lead. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Nice run there.
tosses out to the tailback on the screen.
Tackle at about the 39-yard line.
To get a few yards on the run back.
Yeah, but I'll tell you, Brad, with so much traffic in the middle there, it really makes it tough to break free.
Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. Quarterback all himself from the backfield with five wideouts. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Tackled for a loss. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Five wide. And a quick throw. He's taken down
at about the 47-yard line.
The middle. They'll bring him down at the 32-yard line. They come out on an empty backfield. Throws complete. He's got space to work. He's tackled at the 18-yard line. Ground left side makes it out to about the 10.
Let's get out of the field for the official call.
Offside defense.
That's just a discipline thing there. It's 5 free yards and that could hurt.
First and five, ball on the 13. Strike to his receiver, no good. Throws left, the running back's got it, and they push him out at the 11-yard line, and they pick up 2 yards.
This was just a little dump-off pass to the halfback, but it was very well defended, keeping them from moving the ball very far downfield.
Throws a strike over the middle. Touchdown, Golden Eagles. Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. And he tacks on the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. And he got all this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
And you know, it's basically like we're starting from zero here in a one-quarter game now. Every possession is vital.
Here's a counter, losing yards. It out left to the running back, and he shoved out of bounds
around the 29-yard line.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. And he stopped behind the line.
Well, the question now is, how will they respond after losing a couple on that run?
He he's tackled at the 47. The offense will be hoping they can move the ball as well as they did on their last drive.
It was a really nice drive, too, Brad. The quarterback got into a nice rhythm. He did a good job of picking apart the defense.
He tackles him for a loss. Just nowhere for the ball carrier to go as the linebacker met him in the backfield.
Boy, what great play recognition by this linebacker. He saw the run was coming, and he just shot through the gap and made a great tackle.
Second down, 14 coming up here. Ball on the 43-yard line. Quickly to the tight end, incomplete. They come out in a five-wide set. Pass complete and taken down immediately. The offense didn't appear to be in sync on that series. The Owls taking their first time out of the half. Made at the 20. This is when things get a little prickly. You need your playmakers to really come through here. Just under two to go in the game. Pressure coming and the ball is loose. And they fall on the loose ball. Good tackle there in space. Well, a lot of frustration by that offense, but you've got to give the defense credit for coming up with a stop in this quarter in a game this close. That'll make it fourth and 10. It's a short kick. Brought down at the 45-yard line. Here we are late in the fourth quarter, and this is what this game has come down to. Every possession is going to count, and this could be the one right here. Oh, and a huge drop by the wideout here in the fourth quarter. From the 45-yard line, it's second down.
Let's go! Green check, check! Thunder!
Get to that quickly, and he's immediately tackled. Just a tremendous play there late in the fourth quarter in a tie football game. And now it all comes down to the final seconds or overtime. And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. Up the middle for a nice game. Under a minute left in the game. And he's hit immediately. The end of the fourth quarter, and we're going to take this deadlock into overtime. Back
back to the action here, and we get ready for overtime. Makes it to the 22-yard line. From the 22-yard line, second down. He's in trouble. Now he's scrambling. Quick pass, and he's right there to knock it away.
Coach is going to have to be happy with that one. The defender was in the right position to make the play.
Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. Fires out to his wideout, and he hits him hard at the 12. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Quick strike, and it's caught for the touchdown.
You want to start off an overtime period to put the touchdown on the board and put the pressure now on them. They know they've got to match this touchdown if they want to stay alive.
And he hits the PAT. First and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. Setting up blockers, or running backs got it on the screen. Brought down at the 23-yard line.
Gain of 2 yards. That makes it 2nd and 8.
Black five, black five.
He's hit and taken down. So they go to the air and pick up 6.
The wide receiver ran a simple out route, and the quarterback did a good job of hitting him in stride to pick up a few yards.
It's 3rd down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. The 10 gets out to around the 6. And he's got his man. And a nice move to finish it off. Touchdown. So they come up with the equalizer.
This offense did just what they had to do. They knew they needed 6 points, and they got it. That was just a great series.
We'll be tied with the extra point. He splits the uprights with the extra point.
This is why I love the overtime rules in college football. Both teams had a fair shot at it, and they'll get another opportunity to try it again.
1st and 10, ball on the 25. Here's a screen pass, gets it to the back. He's gobbled up in the backfield. Sophomore, and he's tackled around the 18-yard line. So the quarterback completes the slant pattern for about a 9-yard gain.
That makes it 3rd and 3.
They need about 3 yards to get the 1st down here on 3rd down. Out of bounds at the 10-yard line. They give to the tailback.
And he's level at the 10.
Second and 10. Ball on the 10-yard line. Here's a throw, and it's almost picked. It into coverage, and it's intercepted. From the 25-yard line, first down. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete.
Number two breaks it up. That makes it second and 10.
Man left. Four down. Right, let's go.
They'll spread the field with five wide. Catches it, and that's all. Kirk, that was a nice grab there.
You know, it may be simple, but whenever you can gain solid yardage, you're doing something right.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And down he goes at about the 11. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. They're at the 7. Second down. Tack on any yardage.
Number 17 with the tackle at the 3-yard line. That'll make it a 3rd and 1.
Watch a slap. 15's the mark.
Finds the man. Touchdown.
I give the game ball to the whole defense. Their performance in the first series of the second overtime was just huge. Allowing 0 points in the second overtime really made things easier for their offense.
Really great game to watch. Both teams should be proud of their efforts in this one. Southern Miss, 30, Florida Atlantic, 24. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.